امتن الله سبحانه وتعالى بها علينا نعمة الإسلام. قال الله عز وجل: اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. فالله عز وجل سمى الإسلام نعمتي، يعني وأضافه إلى نفسه، مما يدل على عظمة هذا الدين عند الله سبحانه وتعالى. وهذا من إضافة التشريف إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The brother, أخونا أبو موسى, he began. أبو عبيدة سامحني. He began with these words by mentioning that the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, if you were to count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will not be able to do so. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, today I have perfected for you your religion, وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي, and completed my favor upon you, وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينَ, and I'm pleased with Islam as your religion. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that I have completed this favor upon you and this ni'mah and this blessing. And he says here that here ni'mati, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has connected this favor and this blessing to himself, and this is something of nobility, it being this case of connecting it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وكذلك يا إخوان من نعم الله نعمة السنة. ولهذا ترى أن طالب العلم ولو كان قليل العلم ويفوقه غيره من الطلاب أنه محبوبا عند الناس. وهكذا الشيخ مقبل كما قاله الشيخ أبو بلال الحضرمي كان يقول: في أيامي في الجامعة الإسلامية كان هناك طلاب أعلم وأحفظ مني. وانظروا إلى الثمرات الشيخ مقبل المثمرة، وانظروا إلى بقية هؤلاء الطلبة الذين خرجوا من السلفية والتحقوا بالإخوان المفلسين.
And the brother also mentioned, and from the blessings is that of the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that the students of knowledge, whatever they may have with them, even if others are beyond them in that, they try their best. And an example of this is that of Sheikh Muqbil rahimahullah ta'ala and of his da'wah. And when he was in Islamic University, there were how many other people? But how many of them after were misguided and joined Ikhwan al-Muflisin and the likes of them?
الشيخ مقبل وفق لأنه كان متمسكا بالسنة، وهذا يظهر لكل من ذهب إلى الدماج ويسمع عن أخبارها عن شدة التمسك بالسنة فيها.
And this comes clear when you see the likes of the Sheikh and that of how those that were in the Maj and how they were holding firm and adhering to the best ability to that of the Sunnah.
ثم يا إخوان من نعم الله عز وجل طلب العلم، وكثير من الناس الذين يعرفون نعمة الإسلام ونعمة السنة تجد عندهم غفلة في هذا الجانب بالأسف الشديد. فنصيحتي لجميع الإخوة: الله الله في طلب العلم، احرصوا واعلموا يا إخوان أن الخير يقل وأهل الحق يقلون. وهذا ليس بعجيب، قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما جاء في صحيح البخاري: لا يأتي عام إلا والذي بعده شر من حتى تلقوا ربكم. قال أنس: سمعته من نبيكم صلى الله عليه وسلم.
طيب. And he said also that of seeking knowledge and its importance, and many we find who may love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messenger and love the Quran and Sunnah, they are not ones who have taken advantage of this and are heedless at times of this. And this is something that We find in our times that the scholars are less in number and the people of goodness are less in number. And this is of the trials. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that there will not be a time except that which comes after it is worse than that which is before it. And Anas said, Anas the companion here, he said that I heard this from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
ومن هذا الشر الذي يزداد من حين إلى آخر يا إخوان كما سبق كثرة أهل الباطل وقلة أهل الحق وقلة أهل العلم فلهذا ينبغي لنا أن نستغل من وجودهم.
And this he says that it has become the case that there are many callers of misguidance and many people out there calling to misguidance. So, and less in number of those that we can benefit from. So we should take advantage of this, of taking benefit from those little.
والعلماء يذكرون أن هناك زمن واحد يكثر فيه الخير. من يعرف الجواب؟ متى يكون هذا الزمن؟
He says that, and the scholars they mentioned there will be a specific time, one time that. Is a time of much khair, and so who of us can mention this one time when this khair is? Specific time that there's a lot of khair.
يعني الحديث فيه أن الشر يزداد صحيح؟
نعم.
لكن يوجد زمن واحد يكون العكس بمعنى أن الخير يزداد. من يعرف الجواب؟
He said that there is ماذا? This hadith shows us that. It will get worse and worse. But there was a time where the khair and the goodness came and it looked as if it was, of course, better at that time. So who knows that?
أحسنت. الأخ قال زمن المهدي لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال سيملو الأرض قسطا وعدلا كما مليت ظلما وجورا.
نعم. So the brother mentioned that it is the time when the Mahdi will come and it is said in the hadith that it is a time where justice will become prevalent as it was before oppression was prevalent.
وأختم يا إخواني بما ذكر الشاطبي في كتاب الموافقات ذكر في هذا الكتاب أن الضروريات خمس يعني أن الشريعة بل جميع الشرائع جاءت للحفاظ على خمس ضروريات حفظ الدين وهذا أهم شيء ثم حفظ النفس ثم حفظ العقل ثم حفظ المال ثم حفظ النسل فلو تأملتم إلى حال طالب العلم والذي يكون جادا في طلب العلم تجد أن العلم يكون حماية له في الحفاظ على هذه الضروريات.
And so Islam has come about with those things that should be preserved. And Ash-Shatibi, he mentions in his book Muwafaqat that these can be concise to five. From it is the religion, and that is the most important thing that a person must look towards and must be preserved. And then there is that of wealth and intellect, and that of a person's honor and wealth. These are all things that you find in a student that he will try to preserve.
علمك يحمي دينك من الشرك من الوقوع في الشرك والكفر ونواقض الإسلام والبدعة والمحدثات والخرافات وقس على ذلك.
And your knowledge will be that which preserves you and looks after you in from many affairs, from that of misguidances and innovations and all of those types of things. And let that be something that we can measure with that. Which.
وعلمك يحمي طبعا أيضا عقلك. أنا ما أعرف طالب العلم يطلب العلم الذي يدخن أو يستعمل المخدرات أو يشرب الخمر مما تذهب عقله.
And he said also it preserves this knowledge preserves that of a person's matter his sanity and him being someone who is as intellect with him. And you find them, you don't find students of knowledge now after smoking and committing these types of affairs. They are far from this.
وهكذا حفظ النفس لا ترى طالب علم أبدا يسعى في قتل الأنفس المحرمة وهكذا المال لا تجد أبدا طالب علم الذي أثر فيه علمه أنه يسعى وراء أموال الناس
نعم and he said similarly you find that this knowledge how it preserves you in your wealth and you don't find a student of knowledge going about ماذا doing such affairs such as killing and it looks after the nafs and the person's the lives of the people you don't find a person doing acts such as this knowledge how it has preserved him and this is he said this is that is which I would like to have advised jazakumullahu khairan and as we've mentioned is short words of advice and this is the likes that we'd like to see ikhwani fillah al-musharaka and brothers getting involved in the khair and everyone benefiting from this. This is something that we here wish to benefit ourselves from and all of us benefit in ways that we can try to start thinking about how we can benefit our community and how we can try to rid them from any problems that they're facing. Inshallah, we'll be having food soon. Until then, the brothers, inshallah, can speak and everyone in here can speak and ماذا بإذن الله there will be lectures after Maghrib وجزاكم الله خيراً